And over to the latest on Afghan talks. After 16 days, the peace talks between the United States and Taliban have ended. The talks were on in Doha, the capital of Qatar, and the United States has declared a breakthrough. Most agree some progress has been made. They have a draft agreement, although there is no formal agreement on the withdrawal timeline as yet. This is the longest round of peace talks between the two sides so far, and the talks will resume later this month. So what were the key topics under discussion? The U.S. sought assurances from the Taliban on not allowing militant groups in Afghanistan to stage attacks against the U.S. and Taliban wanted the U.S. troops to withdraw from the country at the earliest. After the talks, the Taliban put out a statement and I quote, "For now, both sides will deliberate over the achieved progress, share it with their respective leaderships and prepare for the upcoming meeting, the date of which shall be set by both negotiation teams." Now, the Taliban's political chief Mullah Abdul Ghani Baradar and a U.S. team led by Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad took part in the talks. Khalilzad took to Twitter to say that the conditions for peace have improved and that both the sides have made some real strides during the talks. Khalilzad said that both the parties have agreed in draft on two of the four key issues. However, the Taliban are yet to talk to the Afghanistan government. So far, they have refused to talk with the government, and the Afghanistan government is hoping for talks with Taliban. At least that's what the spokesperson for President Ashraf Ghani has tweeted. Several countries and organizations such as the UN have welcomed the progress made in these peace talks. They have asked the Taliban to engage with the Afghan government. Listen in.
Despite such engagements, the Taliban have not yet accepted to engage in direct talks with the government. I stress the imperative need for the Taliban to directly talk with the government.
The Afghan government and the Afghan people have made commitments to peace. Now it's up to the Taliban to prove their commitment. They have so far failed to seize opportunities for peace. Yet, we stand ready to engage in direct talks.
It's been recognized that progress has been made, is being made, it's incremental. It's not going to be easy, never was, will not be. We will always have to guard against spoilers. We will require support of regional stakeholders, and hopefully they are coming around and things are moving in the right direction.
So what's next? The respective parties will deliberate on the agenda before the next round of talks. But there is one tricky issue. Violence has continued in Afghanistan even during the course of talks. On Monday, Taliban fighters attacked an entire Afghanistan National Army company of over 50 soldiers in Badghis province. Nearly 20 soldiers were reportedly killed, while another 20 were taken into custody. This is just one of the many instances of violence. A few days ago, 23 members of Afghan security forces were killed in a Taliban attack on a U.S.-Afghan base in the country. Such violence has garnered criticism from international community. Several countries believe that the revival of the Taliban may revive terrorism in the country.
A dovolíme-li Talibánu, aby opět ovládl afgánské území, vytvoří z něho opět teroristickou základnu, sloužící k útokům na území euroamerické civilizace.
And so the talks have progressed without any major breakthrough. Stage is now set for another round, but violence continues. So does the refusal of Taliban to engage with the government?